Showing you how Epsilon could just run all over the place around this entire battlefield in one move. And it just gained 3 more increases to speed. I guess we should spread apart a little bit. Yeah, he's stuck behind here. So don't get all be hit by this sound. This howling. I mean, I don't know how howling can damage you, but okay. Just trying to spread us out a little bit here. He needs to make a physical attack, so we need to get right up to something. Or melee attack, rather. They call it physical attack in this game. Range attacks are also technically physical attacks. So that's why I don't refer to them thusly. He's not going to be able to reach, but he can't move anymore. Something about his thorny tail. Missed. Did they get 2 attacks around? Gnarled thorny tail. Hit his buddy again. Well done. That's all I have to say to that. Well done. He's all right for now. So he ran up to that thing to get a physical attack. Didn't even get to attack. That's the crazy thing. Just trying to space them apart a little. Missed. He can't attack. His foe is killed. He's left feeling dejected. He's gonna do a cone of sound, so maybe not. Missed, good. Hit his friend. Alright, so this is a tunnel of life force drain, which he cannot use because whoever that is and is in his way. Varanus is in his way. We don't want to be hitting Varanus with life force drain. he can't reach. See, it's a lot of positioning and just... I don't even know if he can reach this far either. They're really focusing on him. They're in a challenging fight when you just keep killing them, your friends. Starting to get affected here, but we only got one left. I could bandage him, but let's wait. Let's save our bandages. This battle's gonna be over soon. That would be a great thing. They get two attacks per round, so... missed Epsilon. Too quick for ya. Missed Epsilon again. Who's this? Okay. Suffering severe burns. Feel the burn, man. Feel the burn. Oops. Too quick. Ah! He just can't get a break. He wants to hit somebody, and he can't. Because the enemy keeps killing other party members before he can attack. See, he's standing right in the way. This is a tunnel of life force strain. I think it shouldn't hit him. I hope. Can I hit here? Ah, crap, I hit Killdozer. Ah, really? I killed him. What I was criticizing the Lycanthropes for doing, now I've done myself. I killed my own party member. And I was trying not to hit him. Alright guys, third time's a charm. One more time. After all that. Varanus got two speed increases. Good, he needs that speed. All right, miss. Starting out promising. This guy's toast. Because I'm sure he's gonna do the same and hit his friend. Two hits with the sonic howl. Figure they'd be like immune to it or something. Okay. He's alright still. Alright, let's have him move to the other character. He's attacking melee, so he's gotta be right up to it. And in the meantime, they kill their friends. All right, life force drain. Unaffected. Instead of moving, I'll cast another one. I don't think he can reach. Yeah, Advent. Advent's a very slow mover. Trying to get him up to the enemy. Missed. They are grouped too close together for my liking. What are you gonna do? This is Epsilon. Some more speed. Yeah. Lots of speed, baby. Missed. But you hit your friend. Okay, he missed his friend this time. Oh, tunnel. Tunnel of life force drain. Right? That's what it is. I'm afraid I'm gonna hit whoever that is. I think that's Twin Snake. Sweet. Twin Snake. Thank you. Good. He needs that. Any little bit for these other guys. But Epsilon makes them look like they're standing still. How's he doing? Oh, he's alright still. He's about halfway. Halfway dead. Unfortunately, yeah. He's still not in physical melee range. He wants to howl. Even though he's standing right there, he wants to howl. Done. Duranus getting that speed. 684, sweet. Another battle, or... okay. After the battle is over, you help the bleeding old man up, who introduces himself as Mirach. And to prevent the confusion, he unceasingly continues his speech in a relatively calm tone, which allowed of no reply. So, finally you came, but you were too late. What you have just seen was another perfect example of how this entity of yours manipulates the creatures of the dark side. Hey, it's not our entity. Pearlblood, explain me about the nature of your mission, and originally I wanted to tell you everything about the Guardian, but now the situation has changed with the loss of my grandson Algol. I have nothing more to lose than this boy, but you have an entire world to win. And I know that no one should go into the core of the mine down below, only to rescue a single child, except of you. The unborn knows that until I sense Algo's thoughts, I will not speak to keep him alive, but if you're able to bring him back, I will tell you everything. Take my pass card. It will allow you to open the gate to the ancient mine section not visited by man for 3 centuries. The Lycanthropes, similarly to me or any mutants, are fully resistant to radiation, but you won't endure too much in their radioactive lair, so be very careful. I have to share with you another thing. Algol is a mutant with an unbelievable talent to alter dimensional structures, but he's still not in full control of his skills. Before we were expelled from the Watchtower colony, those animals have treated Algol with a kind of permanent poison. Now, in every 2 hours, he needs a special antidote, so you have roughly 1 single hour to bring him back to me, otherwise he dies. And the unleashing energies of his agony can easily destroy you as well. Is there really a time limit on this? Do we have an hour game time for this? Algol. Okay, I've stumped him. And nothing's responding again. Does F10 respond? I hope so. Otherwise, I have to play this battle over again. Okay, I did have to fight that battle over again. Because unfortunately, while I did press F10 at the end, the game was frozen at that point, I could not save, so I couldn't make an actual save. Ask about what? What's his name again? Algol? Nothing happened when I asked him. If you ask him about Algol, it hangs the game. Good to know. At least this time I save, so I can just restart and load up. Alright, we're not going to ask him about anything, but he does have a key card for us. Area Gate Pass Card. Hey, there are no items! After the battle is over. I guess he doesn't have anything new to say, right? Now they picked up the pass card. So finally you came, yeah. Alright, I want to analyze it, just probably not going to say anything interesting, but just in case, it will. Here we get pass card. I thought we were stuck again. .03 kilograms, speed factor 20%. You can swipe that card at 20% very quickly. Well, I thank you. There's nothing else to say. Let's make it not the active item. Battle situation new. Every time we go talk to him. Yeah. I don't know about medical cabinet. I guess they used all the medicine to, heal themselves after these lycanthropes attacked. I keep hitting that. And in a battle, I hit movement. So we've been down here. Oop. Oh! Battle? Oh hey, it's you! Pearlblood was waiting for you here at the end of this corridor. She looks extremely worried about her son, and she's holding a sparkling item of some sort in her trembling hands. As you reach her, she starts to cry and speak very rapidly. Okay. Let's speak to you rapidly. Oh, please rescue my son. I don't care about any interests, mutants or non-mutants, mad gods, relics, or all this damned world. I just want my dear little Algol back, alive. He's only an innocent child. Please, take this ancient crystal with you. My ancestors told me it brings fortune upon its possessor. Oh, you must save him. I beg you for all goodness' sake. An ancient crystal? What the hell? I'm afraid it's gonna hang again. Sorry, I can't tell you more now. What if I ask her about Algol? Is Algol crash stuff? No, only with Mirach it does. Okay, item. Artificial crystal. Let's analyze it. Point 20 kilograms, 30% speed factor. Okay, yeah, not useful. Alright, we've got this crystal. I have no idea what she wants us to do with it, though. Before I go down. Saving. Alright, saving. Alright, going down. Your nervousness grows as you descend even deeper under the surface. Very nervous. Facing south. Oh, it's another elevator? Now we're facing west. Caution, area gate locking system number one. So we would have been stuck here. We would not have been able to go through without his card. You're unable to open this door. Well, we have to use an item. Wait a second. Yeah, it's this thing. The door opens and slides up. Well, I never would have realized that. Thank you. Another elevator down here? I guess radiation passed here? Goes down even more. Heading west. Warning, separated air circulation system. Do not decompress. The door remains motionless, only a small red light flashes instead. Do we have another card? Oh, we have this, still. I thought that was used up. Nothing special happens at all. Well, rub it in, why don't you? He's got a lot of stuff, and that's the... Yeah, it's not gonna use that. That's... I think that's from back in... Midlight? Midlight City? Alright. So not through there yet. Dust and sharp rocks are lying on the floor. The walls in this section of the mine can crumble at any moment. That's alarming. There's a thing here. An object. A large battle axe. Sweet. Let's analyze it. Oh, analyzer. Six point 15 kilograms, speed factor is 150%. User classes. Oh, Killdozer can use it. 35 wounding, range is 2. Minimum strength 40. And this stuff. Strength of 40. Let me just see this again. What's the damage on it? Wounding 35, right? That's a good thing. Wounding. And physical attack plus 40%. .45 and 40%. Pairing. He did get to use this in the last battle. Guess I should have recorded it. Okay, the average wounding is 14. The Lycanthropes were lucky this time. They only hit one of their own once in that last battle that I had to play over again just to get back to where I was. Yeah, average wounding 14. So they kept hitting Killdozer and missing the Lycanthrope next to him. So he actually got to swing his bayonet a couple times. He was very happy about that. Wounding is 14. 25%. Okay, it's definitely the axe is better. Which I suspected, but I wanted to see. I wanted to compare and make sure and all that fun stuff. Oh, the class of this character is not trained to operate this item. Is that a mercenary? Wait a second. I thought you were a mercenary. What the hell are you? Wait, personal information. Oh, he's an assassin. I guess he's sticking with the bayonet after all. I want to see. His strength is 82, so. But he's an assassin. For some reason, I thought he was a mercenary. Yeah, he can't use. Okay. Never mind. Twin Snake's a mercenary, right? Yes, alright, so I'm gonna give it to him. Because he runs out of his mega bomb gun that he has. Saving again. This is a loop-de-loop-de. Just looking on the map to see where I am. Oh! Okay. I see where we are. And there's something at the end, I think. A monochrome display says composite assembling unit. Oh.